So how accurate are your ethnicity results or admixture results really? I'm going to try to answer that for you today, and it may surprise you. Howdy, I'm Annie Lee with Family History Fanatics, and one of the big draws of DNA testing is that they all tell you a little bit about where your ancestors are from. They give you some results, usually in a percentage of where your ethnicity is, where some of your ancestors were, whether they were from Europe or from Africa or from Asia or from the Americas. And a lot of people are excited about this because they find different parts of themselves that maybe they didn't know about before. But how accurate are those? Now, I already did a video on this where I told you that, yeah, they may not be that accurate. And let me show you today exactly what I mean by that. So I'm going to be using GEDmatch. And GEDmatch is a free program that you can upload your results regardless of what company you tested with. And so it's great for comparing people who test with different companies. And in fact, it's great for comparing yourself with yourself. So today, I'm going to look at the results from Ancestry and the results from 23andMe. And when I talk about this, I'm not talking about what 23andMe interpreted their results as. I'm talking about the raw data. When we compare what 23andMe tested and what sequence they found my DNA has, and what Ancestry tested and what sequence they found my DNA has, how does it match up? Now, recognize that each of these companies, they use a different chip to measure your DNA. And so they're looking at different positions. Now, there's a lot of overlap when we're talking about 500,000 to 900,000 different positions of your DNA, what letter it is. And so when we're looking at the overlap, there's probably at least 200, 300, maybe even 400,000 positions that they overlap, which means those positions should be the exact same. However, when we're talking about ethnicity, companies have to use some sort of algorithm, some sort of program, some sort of formula to look at different parts of the DNA and what sequence it is and decide what ethnicity that falls into. And so since there's only partial overlap between what these two companies test, it's very possible that I may come up with different ethnicities depending on which company I tested with. So looking on the screen right here, you see GEDmatch. And first off, what we're going to do is we're going to do this one-to-one comparison. And for the one-to-one comparison, I'm comparing my 23andMe kit right here with my Ancestry DNA kit, which is right here. So again, this is the exact same DNA, just processed with looking at different markers on it. And so we would hope that this is going to show that it is identical between these two. Now, looking at this, this is a list of all the places where I'm identical, starting at this location and ending at this location. And if you'll notice, it looks like every single chromosome, I am identical. And when you look at the total amount of CM, that's pretty close to the entire total amount of centum organs on the DNA that I have. So let me go back and take a look at another way. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to look at the admixture results. Let me show you how I got there. I went to Admixture, Heritage, and then you can select the project. In this case, I'm just going to use Eurogenes. I'm actually very much European as far as my ancestry. And I want to paint the differences between two kits for all 22 chromosomes, this one down here. So that way I can see on every single chromosome what the differences are between these two kits. I enter in the two kits. Again, I have my ancestry kit and I have my 23andMe kit. Now, the Eurogenes calculator has several different models that you can use, several different populations that it's looking at. I'm just going to be using this K13 one for right now. And you can actually go through and you can try it out on all of these different ones to see what differences these companies are using as far as what they're testing. And then I'm going to continue, and it's going to take a little bit to match up. Now, if you'll notice here, this is showing everything that is in common. And it's color-coded for the different regions, and you can figure out where a lot of these are. So the North Atlantic, well, that's going to be a lot of that Western European. You have the Baltic, okay, that's over in Eastern European. the Western Mediterranean, the West Asian, East Mediterranean. You can see mainly, yeah, there's a lot of this red, this North Atlantic. That would be Great Britain, you know, France, Germany, Scandinavia, all that falls into there. With some little snippets of, hey, this West Asian, that would be like the India or Pakistan, and very few other colors. But if you look carefully on this, and let me zoom in, so you can see just a little bit better. One of the things that they have is what is not in common. So remember, this is me compared to me. It should all be in common. But as we look at it, you can see, hey, there's these little bits of black in all these different places where 23andMe and Ancestry have taken my DNA, and because of their algorithms and because they didn't test all in the exact same spot, they're saying that it's something different. So for instance, they may be saying, one may be saying that this is North Atlantic, while the other saying that no, this is Baltic, or this is Western Mediterranean. And what's neat about this is you can see this on every single chromosome. Now it's not a lot, because like I said, there is quite a bit of overlap. And in the end, it's comparing myself to myself. So if it was a perfect world, this would have no black at all. But because of those slight differences between the companies, there is a little bit of black. So when we talk about our ethnicity, you can see that it's not an exact match to everything. Because even when I'm comparing myself to myself, the ethnicity that different companies are going to come up with is different. And so when we're looking at a broad region, like I said, if you're looking at Europe as general, or you're looking at the Middle East as general, you're looking at East Asia in general, or you're looking at Sub-Saharan Africa or the Americas, yeah, those ethnicities are probably pretty correct. But when you're starting to get down into the country or even a smaller geographic area, you might not put too much faith in that, because there's a good chance that it's wrong. Because in the end, I should be the same everywhere. But as we can see, I'm not. Thanks for watching Family History Fanatics. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below and we'll try to answer them. And if you like this video, make sure you like it, subscribe, and tell your friends about us.